Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in the Cube, and in this video, I'm going to show you a tip that can help folks in your organization get their questions answered quickly by the right people. Let's do this. If you're finding us for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both Patrick and myself. Inside of your organization, people probably have questions as they're working with Power BI, whether you're a small organization or a large organization. And where do they go to get those questions answered? There's a lot of things out there that talk about kind of best practices around building a community inside of your organization. For example, there's the Power BI adoption framework or the adoption roadmap that actually walks through like different ways that you can enable Power BI within your organization. In enterprise organizations, what they have is they call it different things. This could be a Power BI support group, a champions group, or just the folks that really know Power BI with inside of the organization. They're passionate. They want to help people and they want to help the organization grow and be successful with Power BI. Typically, there's a spot where people can go to ask those champions questions. So you may have different tools that you use for this type of Q&A or ability to ask folks. In this video, what I want to do is show you a trick inside of Microsoft Teams that can actually help get things kind of filtered down for the right folks. This is utilizing the tags feature inside of Microsoft Teams. There was a blog post by Steve Campbell. Actually, there was a tweet by Melissa Coates that talked about this with Steve Campbell. And I called up Steve and asked him to explain kind of where he was coming from on that. And it made sense to me how you can leverage these tags to get questions to the right people quickly. So I've got a link down in the description to the blog post that Steve put together. The blog post goes through more than just the tags feature, but I want to zero in on the tags to get them actually set up. All right, enough of all this talking. You know, we like to do it here on Guy in a Cube. Let's do what? Let's head over to my computer and see what these tags are all about. So I'm inside of Microsoft Teams, and we'll see here that there's some questions going on. There's an actual team in here called Power BI Help, general channel, and people can come in and actually ask questions related to Power BI. Now, one thing you'll see here, though, is just Power BI Governance, PBI Visualization. You'll see DAX. These are tags, and they're set up within inside of this team. So why would I use these tags? Well, there may be multiple folks from the champions group that are answering these questions, but not everyone knows everything about Power BI. Nobody knows everything about Power BI. There are things that I know more of and things I know less of. And so with inside of your champions group, you may find that some folks may be really good at DAX. Other people may be really good at just the general Power BI service. And so these tags can be set up to kind of signal those people that are interested in those topics and reduce the noise. So all these, you know, bells and chimes that go off signaling that there's an alert of some kind to go check something out, we can reduce that noise by utilizing tags. So setting up the tags is pretty easy. If we go into the team and we just go to manage team, we can go into the tags and you can define tags with inside of the team itself and then assign people that will get alerted for those tags. So if we look at DAX, we can see it's myself, John Doe, and Patrick LeBlanc. We are the ones that will get alerted if someone tags DAX. Now, why would I want to use this tag? Why not just, you know, do something like this? I can just alert everyone in the team and try and get someone to help me out quickly. Well, you're notifying everyone in the team. And we don't necessarily want to do that because not everyone is going to be able to answer my question. By just leveraging DAX, if I have a DAX question, I can actually get to the specific people that can help me. And now I'm not bugging everyone. And that's the idea here. Let's set up a tag and show you kind of how this works. So I'm going to go to manage teams. There's another tag that I can add. Let's call it gateway. And we'll add a few folks. I'll add myself and I'll add Patrick. So now you can see gateway is here as a tag that can be used. You can go back in the team, people can ask a question and actually tag something with gateway. So when that's done, then activity will get alerted for those folks that are in that given tag. I happen to be one of them, so it's not gonna actually do that for myself. Now, I wanna give you two different scenarios here where this may work and may not work. Inside of Microsoft, you may have heard us talk about the CAT team more than once here on the channel, but they have a channel that's set up for the field to ask questions. In that scenario, I don't know that these tags would actually work well. It may help to reduce noise for some folks, but from a general standpoint, most of the folks are going in and trying to answer those questions anyway, so you don't necessarily need to get the attention of them. It's part of their work stream every day. On the flip side though, if everyone is just busy doing their day job and they're working on items and it's not really a mandatory goal that you have to go answer questions there, adding those tags can help just raise awareness for folks that there's a question there waiting for an answer that you may be able to help. This may or may not work for your organization, but it's definitely something worth checking out to see if this can help cut down the noise inside of Microsoft Teams and get to the right people to answer the question that you need. All right, I want to hand this over to you. What are you using, first off, for your internal champion group? And how are you cutting down the noise so that those questions can get answered quickly? Let me know down in the comments below. I'd love to hear it. If you like this video, be sure to hit that big thumbs up button. Smash it if you so desire. If it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button. And as always, from both Patrick and myself, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.